what we're looking for is going from point A to point C, how far do we go on the X, the Y, and the Z directions? That's what we're looking for the vector. Advance from straight off the problem, right off the geometry. And then we want to find the magnitude of that. So be careful. There's simple mathematics, but looking at stuff in 3D space, it's really easy to goof something up sometimes. And if you'd like to remember delta is the later minus the earlier, and so that would be xc minus xa, and then the same for the other two coordinate directions. And then once you've got that unit vector, you can go back and find the full force vector, because we're going to use it. Going from point A to point C, how far do we travel in the X direction doing that? Delta Y, how far do we travel in the Y direction? And then the same for C. So it's just like this. It's the X coordinate of C minus the x coordinate of A. The later minus the earlier one, we use delta. That comes right off the chart. So let's see. The x coordinate of point C. Read it carefully. That's 4 meters. X coordinate of point A is 3 meters. Is that what everybody read? Is that what you got for that little piece? And then you do the same thing for the I, J, and K. Y, C is at 0, A is at, the Y coordinate on A, 3, so it's C minus A, that's minus 3, J. To get from A to C, we've got to go, minus 1. Am I reading it right? From the Y direction? No, the Y direction was 3. That's why I don't like you to talk and write at the same time. It's so easy to screw up. You have to talk or write, you can't do both. And then the Z component, remember that's the one that goes out the top.
I don't see the Y component being 3 or negative 3. Where am I looking?
Well, we're the Y component, we start at A in the at plus 3Y. We go back to the wall, which is on the XZ plane, which means we go minus 3 to get from A to C. Alex, is that what you got? Is that what you see? Minus 3 for the J component? Taylor? No? delta y is the later minus the earlier. What's the y coordinate of point C?
Point C is zero.
There's the yz plane. There's a whole picture. Yc, the y coordinate of point C is zero. What's the y coordinate of point A? It's back here. It's the same as the radius of the pipe is 3. And so delta y is minus 3. Seem reasonable now? Alex, you're okay with that? John? Comfy with that? Other John?
Yep.
Sub John? Kalen? That's what you see? And what's delta z going from A to, from point A to point C, how far would you have to travel in the z direction?
Minus 2.
Minus 2? Because we start on the xy plane and we drop down 2 meters below that to get to point C. So that's a minus 2. It's all meters. And then the distance between those is 1 squared plus 3 squared plus 2 squared meters squared. Since we're squaring, we don't care about the minus signs. So just for brevity, I left them off. Remember, all three components should be less than 1, and the magnitude should be 1 itself, maybe a little bit of round off error is all, but very, very close, within a couple tenths of a percent, I would think. Negative 2 minus 0, because A is on the xy plane. There's no z component. Okay, we agree? Did you check with somebody? Did you, Alex? You tried to check with Johnny, he wouldn't let you, I saw that. He is not going to get Miss Congeniality this year. Nailed it down a couple other years, but it's not coming in this year. What'd you get for the I component?
0.267.
0.267i minus, because we got to drop down in the y direction a little bit. What'd you get for that one?
0.802j
and minus 0.533. All three are less than one in magnitude, as they must be. And if you check the magnitude, you get approximately one out of that. So now we can do the full force vector. Leave it that way if you want. What we're going to do next is calculate the moment. You can use it that way if you want, but you have to be careful. You have to understand something about matrix math that is pretty easy to forget. So I think you probably ought to just work it out. 21.4. Sound right? Minus 80 times 802, 64, give or take a little bit, and 42.6. Agreed? What should the magnitude of this vector be if you calculate it out? Doing three-dimensional Pythagorean theorem, what should the magnitude of this vector be?
80.
Should be 80 newtons. That's where it came from. Everybody got that? Caitlin okay with that? Agree with those numbers? Agree with the minus signs as well? Minor signs are just as important as the digits themselves. So there's the force, and now we can calculate the moment. Once we know the moment that rope causes as it pulls on this bracket, we can then start to design the bracket so it withstands that moment. Looks like kind of a one of those plumbing fixtures screwed into a wall. You got to make sure that the fixture itself can withstand that kind of moment, plus the anchoring of the screws into the wall, if that's what we're doing. So, the moment about 0.0. How do we calculate moment? Every time. Especially in three dimensions. It's going to be very hard to do just the perpendicular component in three dimensions. We do R cross F. We've got F, just finished that up. Now we know F is a vector form. We can do the cross product at least with that part of it. But we need is R. Where does R go from and where does it go to? Because it's a vector. All vectors go from one place to another. Where does R go from? R goes from the point of interest. So it goes from point A, from point O, goes to where?
Point A.
Alex said point A. Remember what I told you? Remember what I told you about this? I only mentioned it once, so it might have been kind of quick in passing. generally, it's easy to see if we did R from O to where the rope is anchored, that would make some good sense. But we could push on that point just the same as we could pull on that point. There wouldn't be any difference because remember the force is a sliding vector. A pull is no different than a push in terms of what's going to happen to that bracket. So if we look at that as a push on point A, now where does the R vector go? From point O still, but now to point what?
C.
But if we're pushing on point A, the vector C, the force vector doesn't contact point C at all. Here's the flexibility of this, the fact that the force is a sliding vector. R can go anywhere along the line of action of the force vector, because the force vector can slide along that line and not change the problem. We can do R to anywhere. To prove that, we're going to cut the class in half. This is 1/2. This is half of 1/2. And this is 1/2. Jared, you're not going to play. You're busy. Alex, Cody, which way do you want to go? Okay, Alex, you're going that way because you didn't vote fast enough. Cody's going that way. All right, you guys do R as the vector from O to A. You guys do R, O to C. So we'll need those two vectors, O to, actually if it goes from the origin, we can leave the O off as implied. O to A and O to C, and then that's the one you put in there. We already have the force vector as the last part. Don't forget the minus signs. And the units. So, we got a couple minutes. We got about 5 minutes, enough time to do a quick cross product. You three, make sure you get R, A correctly. No sense going to the cross product if you got it wrong. You three, do R, C. Double check it. No sense continuing forward if you got it wrong. Screwed up that shot, didn't he?
I made it better.
You've been in that side of it. You've been lots of my class videos, John. You never made any of them better. Weren't you here the year we had the videographer?
No.
Was in that, you weren't? I think you were in the year I did videotape this one with the webcam.
Yeah. Joey was in the one when you had the videographer.
Gee, now all I need is Matt in one of my videos and I'll have the whole set. Just 101. Academic record of those stingy brothers. Okay, make sure you've got the same position vector as your partners, otherwise you're doing a different problem than they are. Right off the geometry, it's delta x, delta y, delta z for each of the three position vectors, or each of the two position vectors with three coordinates. Caitlin, John, you guys agree on R, C?
No.
Okay. Favorite students. Cody's not going to play along.
It's
gonna lone wolf it.
C is two over. But A is zero over.
You guys doing RA don't care. Don't walk in front of the camera. Because you're not even due in here yet. You guys don't care about point C. Point C has nothing to do with your problem. You guys don't care about point A. Point A has nothing to do with your problem. Other than we used it to find the force vector, but you don't need it for your position vector. Caitlin, what do you have for RC? John, you agreed with that? Cody, you agreed with that?
Yeah.
Okay. And what's your position vector?
R.
R. RA is?
3i plus 3j.
3, 3, 0.
You can add
3i, 3j, 0. And so you can do the cross product. Do it carefully, lots of minus signs, and build up as you go from the recipe. Just to put RA in there. But we're out of time. Come back on Friday with your moment calculation about 0.0. Check with your partners so you don't come in and be immediately embarrassed. And that's a wrap. How much the battery do you use?
Not stopping recording.
Just like push it. Push it once. No, don't hold it. It just fades out. That's